Hello everyone. In this video, we'll be looking at how to configure a payment workflow in Zoho Creator. To help explain the configuring procedure better, let's take the case of an order management app. By following these steps, you can easily configure a payment workflow. The screen you see here is a sample app for a home appliance store. Whenever a new customer makes a purchase, the details are filled in here and then the payment needs to be processed. Since payment occurs right after making an order, we can configure the payment workflow on this form. So, let's see how it's done. Go to the editor, access the workflow section and select the Payments tab. Here, you will find all the payment workflows you have configured for your application. Since we don't have any yet, let's click the Create Workflow button. You must set up a payment gateway on your account to configure the payment workflow. This is a one-time process. Zoho Creator is integrated with these payment service providers by default. If you already hold an account with any of them, you can add and authorize the connection. If you don't, make sure to create an account with the payment gateway you prefer to configure the workflow. You must ensure that the payment gateway that you select will be supported in your country. In this case, we already hold an account with authorize.net. Let's see how to authorize this connection. Give a connection name and click Create and Authorize. In the new window that appears, you need to fill in the credentials of your authorize.net account. The country and currency fields will display the values based on the selected payment gateway. Authorize.net is supported in these countries and their currency types are displayed here. Every payment gateway has such a unique list of countries and currency types supported by them. Let's say your target customers belong to US. Set the currency as US dollars. The country and currency fields will appear only while linking the gateway for the first time. Next, enter your API login ID and transaction key of your authorize.net account. You can easily find them by logging into your authorize.net account. Go to the account section and select settings. In the security settings section, you will find the option to get your API ID and transaction key. These credentials let the payment gateway identify your account and confirm authorization for transaction submissions to get accepted. Give a name to the authorization. This will act as a default connection for all the applications you create later in the Zoho Creator account. You can follow the same process to make connections with other payment gateways as well. However, remember that only one payment gateway can be activated at a time. Click Authorize. The connection we just created can be accessed from Microservices section. When you open the connection, all information about it will be displayed. In case you have multiple connections, the current connection will be shown as active here. Now that we're through the authorization part, let's go ahead and configure the payment workflow. On the configuration window, choose the form that you want to redirect to the payment. Since we're dealing with an order management application, let's choose the order form. The subsequent fields will be displayed based on the form chosen here. All the currency and number fields present in the selected form appear in the amount field. Since grand total is the only currency field in the order form, only that can be seen here. Give a name to the workflow so that it can be later identified and accessed in case any edit needs to be done in the future. You can choose the always option if you want the payment window to be shown on every order. Or you can set specific condition by which you want the payment to be triggered. For instance, the order form allows the user to choose between online payment and cash on delivery. If you want the payment window to be shown only when the customer chooses the online payment option, then you can click the on condition option and choose mode of payment equals online payment. In this manner, the payment option won't show up unnecessarily when a customer chooses the cash on delivery option. You can add more such conditions by clicking AND if you prefer it to take place simultaneously, or by clicking OR if you prefer it to take place separately. By default, Zoho Creator will have an email notification configured on the workflow. It will be sent on the success or failure of a payment. When you tap this tab, an edit option appears where you can customize the message and select the receiver. Since we want customers to receive an email, let's keep the email provided in the form as the receiver. As you can see, the body of the default email addresses the person who logs in. If you want to change it, you can select the Insert a Field option. All the fields available in the form you chose while creating the workflow will be shown in the dropdown. Let's select the name field so that every time the mail is sent, it addresses the customer by the name entered in the form. In the same manner, you can add any variable available in the dropdown into the body of the email. Similarly, you can edit and customize the email that'll be triggered on the failure of the payment action. You can add multiple actions to execute on success or failure of the transaction. Instead of an email, there are alternate options such as SMS, mobile notification, show success message, or redirect to a URL after every payment. Also, you can add, update, or delete a record in a form on successful transactions. In case you need to push data to another service, for example, you can choose the integration tasks to update the order information to the customer profile in CRM. On the other hand, if you want the inventory count to be reduced every time a purchase is made, you can't use any of these three options discussed till now. For such instances, you can make use of the delete script. Here, you can define the logic to update the inventory automatically after every order. All these actions can be associated to the payment workflow. When the payment workflow is triggered, the associated actions will be executed. Let's just stick to email for the time being. Click Done. The payment workflow has now been configured. Let's access the application and place an order. Enter the details. Now, let's select a product. These are sample product details we have. The grand total we have here is a currency field, which we selected while configuring the payment workflow. And let's select online payment. On clicking the Proceed to Pay button, Creator will automatically redirect to the payment gateway. Now enter the bank details and proceed to complete the transaction. The transaction summary can be accessed from the orders report. As you can see, the status shows the transaction was successful. Now, let's check the email for confirmation. Here, you can see that we have received the email, and on viewing it, we can see the context reflects what we customized. In this way, you can easily collect online payments for your business requirements through Zoho Creator application. We hope the payment workflow configuration process is now a piece of cake for you. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.